Hello and welcome Metroid fans to another update and discussion video on Metroid Prime 4. If you are new here to this channel and enjoy what you see, I encourage you to like the video and subscribe, and also turn notifications on, since throughout the development of Metroid Prime 4, we've been covering the game every step of the way, which included the original rumor of Metroid Prime 4 getting announced at E3 2017, which was in fact shared by this channel first. Now, along the way, we've gathered any new info we can find and highlighted various aspects of the game that have been of big interest for Metroid Prime fans, and this video is no different. But this one was actually covered first by a smaller YouTube channel named TNT Big Show, and I'll leave the link to that in the description. But we'll cover it here to make sure the info gets out to more Metroid fans, and there is more to it to discuss as well. So one of the big discussions that has gone on ever since Metroid Prime 4 was announced to have restarted development back in January 2019 was if in fact the game would actually make it out during the lifespan of the current Nintendo Switch hardware. And as myself and some other of my content creator Metroid Prime fans have discussed in various podcasts and videos over the past few years, the earliest we tend to expect Metroid Prime 4 is likely to be around the end of 2022, which is just over a year from now. And during the second half of 2020 and now full-fledged into 2021, there have been countless reports of Nintendo bringing a more powerful Switch to the marketplace and a Switch that could potentially give Nintendo the added horsepower needed to continue to get current-gen ports at lowered settings on PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X as we move forward. But also, this new Switch does in fact seem to be lining up nicely with the potential debut of Metroid Prime 4 in 2021 along with the new console. Since usually when Nintendo debuts new hardware, they show some exciting software that is on the horizon, usually releasing during its first couple years to get things off and running. So the very interesting thing about Metroid Prime 4 development is that we can now see the hiring aspect of the game start to really slow down and get very targeted on what Retro needs to get done now towards the latter half of its development. Last month, we revealed one of the awesome story writers they hired for the game back in 2020, and now this month, we can see that Retro is now hiring for someone to not only polish up the game, but also this position they are hiring for is for future Retro Studio game development as well. So it's looking like Metroid Prime 4 is in fact getting extremely close to entering its final stage of development, where we'll be ready to actually see demo builds of the game being previewed, which hopefully means, and I think this has a great chance of happening to be honest with you, that the game can have its first debut trailer as soon as E3 2021, or around that time when Nintendo is set to reveal this new Switch hardware. And yes, this hardware is still technically a rumor, but at this point, it's the strongest it's ever been in terms of being a reality after all the evidence we've uncovered here on it and all the reports have shown. And then when you combine all the development progress of Metroid Prime 4 now seemingly winding down, the Chozo planet, so to speak, just might be aligning for all of this to be revealed this year. And yes, there's plenty of optimism and hope here for that to in fact happen if you've been following this entire Metroid Prime 4 saga. So Retro Studios is now hiring for a new environment artist to join the team, but it's not just any old environment artist. There are some interesting aspects to bring out from this, so let's take a look at some of the descriptions of duties and requirements that this new position has. So the description of job duties for this new environment artist brings out that they need to have the following: consistently create strong environment assets that demonstrate a solid understanding of the style, direction, and high quality standards for each project. I remember that, each project. And it says create environment scenes, demonstrating examples of strong composition and layout skills while considering hardware and design limitations and overall art vision of the project. Crafts incomplete ideas or verbal direction into polished environments. Encourages visual storytelling that strengthens the presentation of environmental spaces and assets through highly detailed sculpting, composition, and world building, models at high quality and at technical standards. Takes ownership of environmental assets and scene layout while encouraging collaboration across multiple disciplines to achieve high quality, innovative environment art. collaborates with the other environment artists as well as members of other disciplines, concept art slash design. And we'll just briefly touch on the summary requirements. It brings out that they need to have a strong understanding of physically based rendering PBR pipelines, and also they need to have experience with high polygon sculpting and modeling software such as ZBrush and Maya. So taking all this into consideration, if you're a longtime subscriber of this channel, Retro Studios also has some similar jobs posted in 2019 for Metroid Prime 4 for graphical artists and environments working with various highly detailed techniques that you don't see on the current Switch very often, such as physically based rendering and things like high dynamic range lighting and extremely detailed environments and techniques. But for this one in particular, this is the first time they've said that they were looking for someone for more than one project. And they also highlighted that they want someone to be able to basically polish up and complete unfinished ideas with environments they already have. And the reason why this is yet another great piece of news is because when you normally see a new demo or preview of a AAA game, a lot of the time you get a nice vertical slice of a certain area of the game, and when the game is finally released, most of the time the final product is slightly changed in some ways in the same area they previewed it at first. This could be in how a level is designed or how certain characters or enemies are placed, or even certain textures and details are modified to better suit the final version of the game that the director or producer has for their ideas. Also, a lot of the times when a game is shown in demo form, they have to make the demo basically have a beginning, end, and ending. Whereas in the final game, a lot of the times, a previous area that was once just a demonstration is a small part of a larger area they have to rework and make it seamlessly transition into one piece of gameplay. And for me personally, there have been a lot of games I played where I'm in the middle of a game, say halfway through, and then all of a sudden you have that aha moment where you say, oh yeah, I remember that part of the demo they showed at E3 or perhaps at any other place they first showed the game in a gameplay setting. But of course, since that time, it's changed a bit since when you first saw it. So for Metroid Prime 4, I can see this new hire being something similar in essence of Retro Studios having a plan to finish up this game and start work on the next game right after it's completed. It's amazing that it's literally been over 7 years since Retro Studios' last original game was released in February 2014 with Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze. And now it's finally looking like we could very well be getting a first look at Metroid Prime 4 this year in 2021. It's amazing how far we've come, but as they say, good things come to those who wait, right? And even though we've been waiting seemingly forever for this game to come out or even be shown, perhaps even Retro Studios was waiting as well for certain hardware breakthroughs to be completed by Nintendo so they could show their best version possible of Metroid Prime 4 to the fans and of course to the new audiences that haven't experienced the game yet before. We all want this game to be amazing, no doubt, but I think Metroid fans also don't want anything to be hindering the development of this game at all, and Retro Studios, as we've seen over the last few years, has been hiring AAA developers who have worked on games using the most cutting-edge technology and from the biggest games around. So for Metroid Prime 4, just how far Retro Studios will be able to push their own game development and technology for this game is all dependent on the hardware and their own talents as game developers. Something to keep in mind though about Retro Studios is that each and every single one of their releases in the past has always pushed the hardware to new levels. Even both Donkey Kong Country games from Wii and Wii U pushed those systems respectively to the best they could do within a 2D gameplay aspect. So if Retro Studios is debuting Metroid Prime 4 on brand new hardware for Nintendo, my guess is that it will be yet another showcase for that new console's graphical features and will set a new milestone for the potential of where Nintendo first party games can go from here on out. Now, as you can imagine, there is a lot riding on Metroid Prime 4 for the future of the franchise and if we get continued games in the series. And there's also a lot riding on Retro Studios themselves since it's been so long since we've seen a game from them at all. Do they have what it takes and will Metroid survive? Those are the questions we will have to wait and see, and we will soon find out. But for me, personally, I'm extremely confident that Retro Studios will be knocking it out of the proverbial park with Metroid Prime 4. We just need to see that first debut trailer and we'll be set to see where the series is heading. But until then, What we've seen so far can in fact give us a lot of hope that everything is heading in the right direction. So that's going to do it for this video, guys. Thank you all so much for watching and supporting the channel, and I'll be back with more Metroid Prime 4 content in the very close and not too distant future.